There are lots of great multi-tool brands out there, no doubt, but in my mind, they all still are measured up against Leatherman tools. We've got a handful of them here on the table today. We've got the Leatherman Mutt. This is a full-sized tactical multi-tool designed to help you maintain your AR-15, as well as take care of lots of other tactical needs and tasks. We've got a pocket-sized Leatherman Juice. This is the CS4, a really handy one for hiking or any other kind of daily use. The pocket size, or keychain size really, Leatherman Squirt PS4. This is one that I'm never without. Pretty much have it on me all the time. The excellent Leatherman Charge, fantastic tool in a full-size configuration. Really good stuff. This stuff is really high quality. It's made in the USA. It's backed by a serious 25-year warranty. Like I said before, this stuff is the standard by which all other multi-tools are measured in my mind. So how can Leatherman improve what they've done? And how can they get innovative? Well, what they've tried to do and what I believe they've succeeded in doing is created something that's really unique, really special, pretty functional, and just dang cool. And that is the Leatherman Tread. The wearable multi-tool, the first Leatherman that is a wearable multi-tool. This thing was announced at SHOT Show 2015. I was among the first people that got to see it and got to experience it, got to get one in hand. I was one of the handful of guys that was given one to take home and play with. They might have expected me to do a review on it sooner. Honestly, for your benefit, I'm glad I didn't. There's a lot of things I've been able to learn about this, some good things, some bad things, that have definitely informed my opinion of this bracelet slash multi-tool. And those are pretty much the two roles that this thing fits into. It's a cool piece of jewelry and a pretty functional multi-tool. And we'll talk about how valuable it is in both of those roles. So let's go ahead and clear the table just a little bit here, move some of these pieces out of the way, and we'll talk about how and why the Tread is both of those things, both a really nice bracelet, a cool piece of man jewelry, and a good multi-tool. In my opinion, it is more bracelet than it is multi-tool. This is an awesome, really cool piece of man jewelry. And let's get this question out of the way first. Is man jewelry something that you would ever buy? Do you own a nice watch? Then yes. Do you own a couple of nice watches? A handful of nice watches? Then yes. Any rings? Yes, okay? There's a ton of expensive man jewelry out there that if you haven't bought it, trust me, lots of other dudes have. And they buy it for no other reason than it looks cool. By the way, do you have a really nice pocket knife? Here's one. Actually, not a really nice pocket knife. That's the Lightning OTF. It's really functional, it's fast, it cuts stuff, but guess what? Not something that I'm gonna flaunt and be like, wow, look at what I got a Lightning. Oh, you look at you and your Lightning, oh, special. Here's one that I might wanna flaunt and show off. The new Microtech Ultratech with the, what do you call this again, tri-grip grip on it, aluminum frame on it. Really new, really interesting. There is absolutely no reason I should buy this if I have this when I'm speaking strictly to function. All right, this is definitely better steel. There are other things about it that are functionally much better on the Microtech. But if I just want to get a handful of things cut and cut well, yeah, the Lightning does just fine. And it's got some of that cool factor too. So why am I bringing up knives? Well, simply because I, for one, own lots of knives, and most of them because I like them. Not at all because I need them. So the Tread, in that sense, is not something that you're buying because you need it. Because you're like, wow, I gotta have a multi-tool that can go on my wrist that I can take anywhere. So if I ever need to, I can take it off and I can get a little Phillips screwdriver on here and screw something down. Or I can get one of these little hex bits or, you know, one of these Allen head screws and screw something. Or the oxygen key right here and turn something on or off. Or any one of these other tools that are on here, I gotta have this with me in order to be able to use all that. You know what? You can just have this if you wanna have all that functionality. And in most people's cases, you can carry this just as easily. I would say most guys can. Definitely you can carry this as easily, maybe much easier, depending on what you like having on your wrists. So from a functional standpoint, no, come on. We don't look at this as simply a functional tool. What it is an awesome piece of man jewelry that also has some great functionality to it. And at around $165, there are a lot of guys out there that totally want it and will buy it today just for the fact that it looks cool. Let's move on to the other use that this tool has, this multi-tool bracelet has, and that is that role of a multi-tool, of actually something that you can do some work with. Does the tread get some good work done? And how well does it do it? Well, I've put this through a handful of tests, so we'll go through some of those as we show you some footage and video. It can lift bottle caps with this little cap lifter right here. That works just fine. And in fact, I would say that the cap lifter here on the tread is better, at least, than the one on the squirt. And I'll pull that one out real quick to let you see what it looks like. The reason why the one on the squirt is so ineffective in my estimation, I don't lift a lot of bottles, or bottle caps I should say, but it doesn't have a very deep hook right there. The one on the tread is deeper, so that will hook your cap and pull it off a bit easier. So that's more effective. It's got some nice bits on it, some nice screwdriving bits on it. You can see some witness marks there on that Phillips head. I will tell you this, the Phillips heads are a little more durable than some of the others. And we will point to this one right here. And again, we're going to get to more detail and some footage of some of this stuff in use. But is it this one or is it another one? I think it was one of the other ones. Let me find it here. I think it's that one. Yeah. You can see what it looks like even more than just a witness mark, where the head has actually twisted around just a little bit. If you put a good deal of torque on some of these tools, you're going to get not just witness marks, but a little bit of bending. And why is that? Why are you seeing that? Why would you see that on the tread and not on some of the tools from the Juice? Here are some of the screwdrivers from the Juice. And you know, they're built differently. That's what it basically comes down to, is this is made out of a different kind of steel. The steel that we have on almost all Leatherman tools has more carbon in it. I don't remember the name of the steel, but it is tougher. All right, it is heat treated and it's a tougher steel all around. Whereas what we have on the tread, because of the nature of the fact that you're wearing it on your wrist, you're going to be dealing with sweat, you're going to be dealing with water from washing your hands, things like that. You have to have a more stainless steel, something that is far more corrosion resistant than any of their other stuff. So not as tough as other Leatherman multi-tools. We need to address that for sure. The tools on here they won't hold up to the same amount of torque, to the same amount of abuse that these other tools will, and yet they are quite functional. So we're going to move on to some more of that functionality. One of the neat tools on here is this one right here. What it looks like is a little pick, and that's kind of what they call it, but I use that as a SIM card extractor, which works really nicely. And if you happen to work someplace where you're going to be swapping SIM cards in and out of phones frequently, maybe you work for an IT department of a company or something like that, that might be something you have to deal with frequently. And having that tool handy could be really useful. We've also got, like I said before, some of these Phillips head screwdrivers. This one right here has not seen any use yet. That's a smaller Phillips head. The fatter Phillips head I have done a fair bit of screwdriving with and found that to be quite useful. One of the neat things about that is you can actually get that thing locked into place and then use the bracelet itself for all the torque that you want to turn that screw. So you're not using just that one link in the bracelet to do the work. You're actually using the entire bracelet as you're turning, which actually it gives you more torque than a lot of screwdrivers would, which is a really, really cool feature. And again, they are limited in their reach without question. You can see they're very short. If you need to reach into somewhere or have a lot of, a long stretch to reach it, then this won't work, obviously. You need to get a long shaft that can do that kind of work. As I said before, it has some of these little Phillips drivers on it. And I'm not going to go through all the details of all of them necessarily. That's a 1/4, as you can see. But I have used one of these other Phillips here to fix a little, it was a towel rod in my house, actually. It was just chronically coming undone, and so I went ahead and tightened that sucker back up using one of these little Phillips heads, which happened to be the exact right size, and being able to have that handy, again, on my wrist, just take it off and get the job done. Isn't that the point? of a multi-tool in the first place, you know, having the multi-tool on you is the real luxury of it. You know, you can get the job done and get back to whatever it was you're doing. We got a couple of other interesting features on here, including the cutter. The cutter right here, because it is made of the same steel as everything else on the bracelet, which is that somewhat softer but more stainless steel, it doesn't hold an edge for a very, very long time. So you can get a good edge on that using something like your Spyderco Sharp Maker, but it doesn't hold that edge for a really long time. Pretty much if you get it nice and sharp, then you slice some cardboard or slice some paper with it, it's pretty much coming undone right away. It's not gonna hold an edge a long time, but if you get it nice and sharp and then leave it that way, then sure, it'll be ready for you when you need it. And on the opposite side of that same link, we have what looks like what they call a scribe. You could use that to score things for sure, but it's also potentially a glass breaker. You can compare that to a glass breaker right here on the Benchmade, what's this one called again? Let's go ahead and open it up. Yeah, the 6800 ambidextrous push button, APB. And let's look at those two glass breakers. Pretty similar in, you know, sort of the point they come to, and made of similar material. I tried to break some glass with the glass breaker on this tread. I didn't have access to like a, you know, a car window, a door window or anything like that. But what I tried to use instead was just a little jar, you know, a little Tostitos salsa jar or something like that, and just kind of bashed away at it a few times. Based on probably the hardness of that type of glass and the fact that it's not designed to shatter the way safety glass is in a car, I did not get any sort of shattering from it. I probably could have kept going and destroyed that thing, but, you know, with all the force it seemed to need, I didn't want to risk cutting myself, even though I did have a couple of gloves on, a couple layers of gloves. But I chipped away at that glass for a good long while, saw some good chips flying out of it, so that tells me that this is a nice, hard glass breaker, and there are no witness marks on the glass breaker itself, which is a good sign. Now, an interesting point about the glass breaker, you can see this, that is actually a separate part which appears to be sort of glued in to the bit, or to the link. Now, I love this idea, and I would love to see on a V2 of the tread, maybe have lots of these tools done that way. That way you can have a harder screwdriver, you know, sort of inserted into the link that is made of some of that same hard steel from some of the other tools and won't get the witness marks so quickly. Perhaps that would cost more money because there'd be more assembly to it. But if there's some way they could engineer that so that it doesn't cost as much to put together, I would suggest that as an improvement, at least on the cutter and maybe a couple of the screwdrivers. Maybe just the flathead ones or the small flathead ones so that those would be a little bit stronger. And I'll also point out that these links are all replaceable. So as you wear one out, you can buy it again and replace it. And you can also kind of replace things to get the exact right fit that you want. As you can see here, I have two of this half link right here. There's one and then the other one. They're identical. I have two of those on there. And that is because it gives me a better fit. So I actually swapped that into the bracelet and swapped this link out with the two fatter flatheads on it. So those would be a little bit tougher flatheads. And again, this means that you can sort of build your tread into the tool that you need it to be, or the bracelet that you want it to be, bracelet slash tool that you want it to be. And I see actually a lot of improvements and a lot of variations of this tool coming. It's currently offered here in this stainless steel as well as in a black version. They have a watch version, as you guys have probably seen. This is really old news. I mean, it's been 10 months since this was unveiled, and I've been wearing it and carrying it and using it in those 10 months to get the real deal on this thing. You know, so it's not just a whitewashed, hey, isn't it cool kind of review, but I wanted to really put it to use, develop some good opinions, get the information about this thing in a thorough way so that you guys know if this is really worth owning, picking up, and if it's really that good of a tool. And in my estimation, yeah, once again, if you are that guy who is totally happy to throw down a couple hundred bucks on this watch and that watch and that watch and this watch and 300 bucks on that pocket knife and whatever, and you're just into this stuff because you think it's cool, then the Tread is for you. This is the kind of thing that you would be into. For the rest of us, for those of us that are just about practicality and just want some good tools, and we don't care about the look and whether we look cool carrying it or whatever, there are so many other excellent tools that Leatherman makes that fit the bill in regard to that. And any of those will do the job. That's not the question, though. The question is not, are there other great multi-tools for you? The question in this video is, how does the Leatherman Tread do as a multi-tool? I think it does actually quite well, given its limitations. And there's no doubt that as a piece of man jewelry, oh man, I don't think you can top it. It just doesn't get much cooler than a wearable multi-tool. And that's my review of the Leatherman Tread, long awaited by some. And I hope it was worth it, guys. I gave you the best information I could muster that I could find. And yeah, there it is. Thanks very much for watching. I'm the Late Boy Scout. Y'all take care.
A similar design to our Mutt series, and make it into more of a outdoor-friendly survival multi-tool so people can feel prepared when they're heading outdoors. And this could be anything from a day hike to the kids. You don't know what the weather's going to bring. To somebody who